He was worried about a sort of a lingering problem from a concussion in spring training, and he consulted a lot of neurologists during the season. I'm pretty sure that had a huge effect on his decision to retire at the end of the season. So in one sense, it is surprising, and yet in another sense, if you look at the context, maybe it's not so surprising. There's a lot of guys who've played 5-6 years and bankrolled a lot of money are now going to start thinking seriously about getting out of the game with more good days ahead of them than behind them. And that's going to make a big difference for Roger Goodell and his image crafters to come up with some way to convince these guys that a long-term NFL career is still a rewarding and completely good decision. In one sense, I think the reaction to Chris Borland's decision was one of the most heartening things and also at the same time one of the more disturbing things for the NFL. Fans have really come around on the idea that players should have some right to determine their long-term health, which only 5 years ago, maybe 10 years ago, was a foreign concept to most fans.